All right. The diamond shatters. The pieces are evaporating in the air, leaving naught but smoky steam. Free at last! I do not know thee, but I have known of thee since the times when it all began. My time is short, he says, before giving probably a 10-minute monologue. For as you can see, my body has long ago died, and it is only through the last vestiges of my former power that my spirit has held this final grasp upon your world, so that I may speak to you now and aid you in your quest. I will tell you a story, and let this story serve as a warning to you and they who will try to follow in your steps. I am half of the former wizard known as Zorphetus, whose bones you see on the mantle before you. 120 years ago, I engaged upon the quest for the Cosmic Forge, the Bane Pen, from which are writ the workings of all the universe. To speak of the pen, I must speak of the Circle, the blessed altar from which the pen was stolen. To protect the power of the pen, it was written that the pen was only to be used upon the Holy Circle, and thus it came to be. In order to wrest the pen from the Circle so as to free it from this mandate, it was necessary to contrive the exception, the singular exception, which ensures the freedom of the pen and likewise does not violate the original order. Thus the great exception was formed, that whosoever shall scribe with the pen not upon the Cosmic Circle will suffer his writ as a bane and shall not rest or be freed from it until a new generation has passed, that time being exactly 120 years, and after that shall he be of his own doing and free from the writ and the bane. My time is at end, for thee has come and set me free, and as my bones lie before you, this becomes my doing, a fate that releases me from my curse. Now listen as I reveal to you those events which long ago transpired, so that you may act wisely and rightly. Once I was Zorphetus, a great wizard of magic and power, and like all who taste of power, the more I drank of it, the greater became my thirst. So it was that I came to make an unholy pact with another whose hunger was a copy of my own, and together we held the dream of universal domination. When at last we heard of this cosmic pen, we knew that to take it and make it our own would make our triumph complete, and so we plotted a scheme which yielded us the Cosmic Forge. But how soon we learned of the bane that follows, should the forge be removed from the circle as we had done. Yes. Once I was Zorphetus, and I was determined to defy the fates, and so scribed the words which told of this mortal wizard, which should be called Zorphetus, and how he shall know all things in the universe, that he will then know how to evade that dreadful bane. And yes, I came to possess full knowledge of everything, and with it was I ripped asunder, twain into two beings, for the nature of all things is divided, that much it is and is not, and thus, as the knowledge lived in me as one, thus it must pass that I then become divided. For, as I know all, I must also know nothing. As it was that a man shall know good, so was I compelled to also know evil. Everything which is known is divided, and that which is not divisible will never be known. Thus shall men forever seek to know, and thus will men always be divided. This is the nature of knowledge, and I tell you that this is how it lives inside of you. This is how you know, this is how you think, this is how a mind believes, and how a mind speaks unto itself. But time grows short, and there still remains much I must tell you. Though I, Zorphetus, am dead, Zorphetus, my other half, lives on, and as I do but aid thee, he shall do but harm thee. His knowledge is incomplete, since I possess its complement, and he can but stumble blindly, half right and half wrong, in everything he does, a mind forever floating through a pool of darkened waters. He is insane, as am I, but you must seek him out, for as I know of the pen and the why, and do tell you, he will know the where and the when of it, but not what, and he will not tell you. That is what must be discovered from him, and with him lives the fate of the forge, the pen, and hand of destiny. I am free at last, and the vision softly fades. So having rent asunder your minds with that, is dumb. To give you the cliff notes, he was a super powerful wizard. He got this thing, stole it away, gave himself all knowledge, but drove himself insane doing it, and now we gotta fix this fuck up. Also, we want the pen. Sorry, I dozed off. Can you repeat that? You can back up the stream and rewatch it as many times as you need to. But the big deal is that we're gonna loot his corpse. All right. Key of Wizard Cave, very important. Wizard's Cone, Rove. The Wizard's Ring is actually a key. Staff of Missiles is probably vendor trash. But I want to look first. I want to see if it's a reach weapon. Poles and staves. It is not. That is vendor trash. And the Book of Weakening can go to Rove. All right. Literally, yes. If Rove can't kill a man with it, he does not care. All right. So I want to check. We got that ring. I want to know what the Ring of Wizards does. Miscellaneous armor, perhaps? Yes. Wizard's Ring. Minus one AC, it is a word decoder, and it gives 10% magic resistance. All right, let's go ahead and dump some stuff here. Drop the fireball. What is this Book of Mantras? Is this, it's a spell. It's a spell he can use. Let's find out what it is. All right, Rove learned a new spell. What is it? I don't know. Let us go ahead and pull the cone. Let us go ahead and pull the ring. Does he have... He's wearing the skull cap. I assume that the cone is probably better. Bullwhip. Green parrot. Wizard's cone. Robes, robes, sandal. Green parrot remains uninvoked. Swag bag, the ankh. Swag bag, the skull cap. Remove the Book of Weakening. Use the Book of Weakening? Alright, Rove learned a couple new spells. Curious what... Mantras might have been... No, it wouldn't have been sleep. Honestly, don't know. I can look it up, I suppose. Control F, Mantra... Stamina. Okay. That's exactly where I would have gone with that. Can you multi-class into Trogdor? No one is that powerful. However, it's funny that you mentioned that because I'm actually wearing a shirt right now. Can I get a me? Oh God, come on, really? I'm wearing a shirt right now that is totally, oh my God, where's the camera? Wrong way. This totally fucking Trogdor. You can't see it, but there's a muscly arm on there and everything. It's pretty great. So yeah, thematic. Camera, what are you doing? Why are you on a weird angle? I didn't tilt you that much. Oh God, OBS. Get out of here. There we go. A shirt to burninate with. Okay, so we got some doors in here that we might be able to get into now, if I can remember how to get to them. Actually, no, these things are probably immune to psionic blast. I'm just gonna try it out, but I don't think it's worth it. OBS. Yeah, all the kids nowadays probably just use the Streamlabs streaming suite, which is just OBS with a wrapper and a bunch of tracking crap tacked onto it. Oh, another thief level. Upside of thieves is that they level really quickly. I prefer OBS to like the Streamlabs and stuff. Of all of the recording software that I have ever used, it's been, I think, the easiest to just generally deal with. Yeah, it is definitely on occasion kind of fucky about things though. Okay, let's see. Key of Wizard Cave.
Aha!
All right. Really, wall worms? Why? And I keep forgetting that Chunk has spells and I need to have him casting them. Same with Sin. He needs to be casting his ranger spells, which... Yeah. Healing touch. Gold leaf. Make with the blades. They're very effective. Rove. Also. Is Crazy MC Evil Wizard gonna be a boss fight? Yes. He's not... Is he the final boss? I don't think he is. Well, I take that back. Okay, so this game has multiple endings. This game has three different endings. In two of them, you leave on a spaceship. We're not doing either of those. We're taking the ending where we take the Cosmic Forge. Depending on the endings you go through, there's like an optional mega boss. This game actually has a couple optional mega bosses in it. One of which we're going to be meeting probably this play session. Suddenly a giant serpent leaps out of the shadows and dashes towards you. Well, it's about time someone came and let me out of here. You have any idea how long I've been locked up in here, huh? Do you? 120 years, that's how long. And let me tell you, if I ever get my tail on that stupid imbecile Zorfidus, I'll make mincemeat out of him. Anyways, thanks for letting me out of here. By the way, my name is Mr. Paphos. I was once the apprentice of Zorfidus, the wizard, that is, until he locked me in here and forgot about me. I know, you're wondering, just how did a big snake like me become the apprentice of such a great wizard? I'll tell ya, because I'm not a snake. Or at least I wasn't until that foul pen came along. That accursed pen. Oh, thinking about it burns my skin. All I did was sneak in and use it just once. Just a few words to make me dashing and attractive, so that the queen might have me as one of her lovers. And that I would live in safety from the wrath of the king. And now look at me! The queen loves snakes, so I was turned into a snake! And the wizard locked me in here. He thought I'd make a good pet, and so I was safe from the king! Oh, that stinking pen. You do you, Mr. Paphos. I don't think we can actually do anything with him meaningful. Okay, now we're done with you, snake boy. Goodbye. Yes, the queen is, of course, there's a term for it. Walking snake. But yes, she's a snake lover. Pen is indeed mightier than the sword, and no amount of swordsmanship will save you from it. Oh, is this a shortcut, I dare say? Oh, it is! Wonderful. No, there's a specific term for people that are attracted to snakes. And it's not scaly, no. Seriously? Just a dead end? And that hard to believe. But okay. Skeletons lying within open alcoves with rumors so numerous, it seems likely this was the castle morgue. One of the skulls has had several cubes of bone removed. Curt reminder that brain surgery has always been a hit and miss kind of proposition. Neat! A fitophile, thank you, Jamalus. All you need are like some asterisks to the side of that and a space between each letter, and it'd be how they denote boss fights in this for the later bosses. These things are immune to psionic attack as well. We'll try a fireball. Chunk punches poisonous slimes. What we got? Nothing. Nothing. And nothing. This room has nothing in it. All right, good talk. I'm glad that we came here. At least we got a shortcut. All right, well now it's time to go back to the beginning of the game. I should save. This is why, by the way, that I have the mini map. So when I'm just zipping through shit, people actually know where I'm going. Hey, gold boldly. I believe you have the hook and rope. Yes. Save in case of fall, yeah. Yeah. So now, let's see, was it here? Yes, okay. So, we got that key at the end of the, or in the Amazon pyramid. That opens the door at the end here. But this door actually opens with that ring we found, which is the stupidest fucking trolley piece of bullshit, because they give you no hint whatsoever that that's what you do. It's just pure adventure game logic. Wizard's Lair, beware of cat. All right, we're gonna do this one first. I remember that cat. Ruby eyeball. Ruby eyeball. Glowing gem rests in each eye socket, giving the skull a demonic face and sinister smile. Saving. Not even say no, there is no text whatsoever when you approach that door. Stepping into the open air, your nose detects the scent of water as if you were near a lake or something. And then you see it, surrounding your rock ledge, winding as far as the eye can see into an underground cavern in all directions, and then disappearing into the mists. A circular emblem is engraved upon the floor, adorned with many strange runes and mystic symbols. Inside the circle, a scene depicts a boat carrying a tomb in flames across the water. So this is the only other game tile we're going to ever see in this water. I don't remember if it kills us if we try to walk into it. No, not on water. It's Wizardry VII where we get the swim skill and we're gonna have to spend hours grinding it. And by hours, I mean I'm going to use a save game editor to just max everybody's swim skill out, because ain't nobody got time for that bullshit. Cat has 20 levels of sorcerer. No! Cat's an adventure, though. It's actually probably one of the cooler looking monsters in the game. Inside, all is peaceful until a demon cat from hell appears. So this thing's a bitch because it blinks. So, like, half of our attacks are just going to be completely useless against this thing. So we'll try and get buffs going as we can here. Try weakening it. Chunk. Try poisoning it. Scimitar, try... try blinding it. Gold leaf. Haste. Just yes. I don't remember if this thing casts spells, but I'm gonna fire shield us just to be safe. Blinks out. Oh, it does breathe fire. Okay. Front row only by the look of things. It's immune to all of our everything. Farming cats from Hell and Might and Magic 2. Oh man. The sleep zone in Wiz 2. That's, or in Wiz 7. That's like at the very beginning of the game, isn't it? There's that field of flowers that knocks your party out. Alright, we're just gonna start.
It just works.
I wonder if we can nail this thing with a deep freeze. This could be hilarious. Alright, we got haste. Let's get Bless going. Rove, now's your time, buddy. Okay, it's phased in. Oh, unaffected. This thing might just be like crazy resistant to spells. We may just have to like beat it to death. This is what happens when Owlcat gets hold of a displacer beast and puts a dozen fiend temples onto it. I mean, you're not wrong. It is pretty on point for Owlcat balance. Chunk up there like punching and wrestling with this thing. Oh, we killed it. All right, that wasn't bad. Fucking 3,500 XP. Can I leave and fight it again? I mean, that's, I think, though, the first fight that we've ever actually fought with, like, all of our buffs running, though. All right, OE. The Vorpal Blades. Could be like all of the everything. Is it Vorpal Blades? No, Cloud of Fear. Oh boy, an armor plate scroll. I care about none of this. ECIM. Oh no. Oh, we got it. Some books. Book of Rapture. What? The fuck is that? Book of Rapture. Yes, Book of Rapture. Charm. Hey. Here you go, Rove. Macho Man, save us. It's a porno mag. Good lord. Oh, he can't use anything because his entire party is just paralyzed. And have some sleep here. We get ganked by another Cat of Hell gating in on top of us. Oh no! Worms! Whatever will we do? Not vines. Is a wrestling RPG. I actually think I know what you're talking about, Kibitz. Where it's got like all the... I shouldn't say all. It has a bunch of like old name wrestlers and stuff in it. Larian combined with Owlcat, a heavily pimped out hentai games. Man. And it's continued like goal of just completely ostracizing me. Steam, they have their like front page game recommendations. And they do the like games recommended based on what you've played. BFRMI. Firebomb. They have like their game of all like recommendations based on what you've played. And for most of the time for me, it's stuff that's like, yeah, okay, tangentially related to things that I would actually play. But man, I don't know how they got from A to B on this one. Earlier today, they recommended me this like orc massage game that is apparently some porno like elf massaging simulator. And I'm just like, what? Ooh, energy drain. I don't even know what that does, but for those potions, I'm not eating it. We're reloading. That sounds about right, yeah. I like muscle girls, that's true. But like, damn. Really, you guys? Really? 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 Oh boy, all right. I need to read that wizard's thing. An inflation-free kink game that Seth reviewed. No, I don't watch Seth's videos. There's too much like dog whistling bullshit in them for me. Not a fan. Okay, Rove, let's go ahead and have you read these books. Swag, remove, wizard's record. Can I use it? You are able to read the following passages. Oh God. Oh God. Month of Stars, 17th day. I have at last achieved success with my experiments in body reanimation. The poor victim was the mistress who accompanied the Vicar, the horror mother of the demon child, and while she had been dead nearly 3 days, still did she breathe, walk, and see once again. It is a pity there was not a way to similarly save her mind and soul, as now she is but an empty corpse. I have sealed her in one of the castle spires until discovering a means of proper disposal. So that's that rotting corpse that we bumped into fairly early on. Encouraged by these early results, I shall continue when another test subject is available. Month of Stars, 23rd day. My latest subject, the insane Vicar of recent beheading, was a stunning experiment in corporeal separation. The moment the axe fell upon him, I invoked a magic which preserved his spirit from departing this world. His mind and soul thus captured, it proves that my ideas will work, and soon I will have mastered both life and death and acquire immortality. For the time being, a spirit lock should confine the departed Viker's ghost inside the other spire, and I will keep the key here, lest some unsuspecting turd loose this wraith upon us by accident. Month of Moon's fourth day. We have at last uncovered the secret portal, which shall soon bring us the Cosmic Forge, and I must prepare for the journey for tonight. We fly. The 13th, we've stolen the forge. The 15th, I'm afraid that my wily apprentice, Mr. Paphos, has disappeared. There are no indication of him anywhere, and all magical attempts at locating him have resulted in failure, other than leading me directly to the den of an overweight serpent, of which I think must have surely consumed him. I have finally decided what to write with the pen, and thus escape that horrid curse which has already taken the king to his everlasting death. Thus, tonight, I inscribe destiny. Oh, it's so fucking, like, just direct line to his face, huffing those farts.
Thus, I inscribe destiny.
And as the last entry in the book, all other pages are blank. Can I just dump this thing? We don't need it anymore. No. Wonderful. Okay, so he mentioned there being another spire and that we found the key in there, so let us go to the other spire. Wizard seems pretty evil. Well, yes, absolutely. Zorphitus was not a good man, even before he was mind busted. Alright, spire key. The door is solid black and looks to be quite heavy. Bolted to the center of its face is a black iron spade. And so now, finally, we can use this other key of spades. And guess what, guys? We're gonna be ambushed by more reading. The room is barren and quiet, looking quite undisturbed for over a century. As you cast a gaze about the chamber, you notice an eerie glow beginning to congeal within its center, taking the shape of a human figure. Soon you can discern a face, old and withered, and now it begins to speak. Hello? Hello? Is that you, Annie? I can't see Annie. Are you okay? Are you okay, Annie? Don't you remember me? I don't know who I am. I remember. I'm not gonna read this. He was a holy man, pious and revered. Doesn't remember. He remembers sweet Annie. He broke his vows and he is punished. The daughter. We have to hide our little girl. They'll come and take her away. No, she is the devil. Oh, she who conceived from sin. She is damned. And it is we who are damned, Annie. The king has found us. He will protect our daughter such a long time. Hey, Moody, good to see ya. Okay, so basically, he was Annie's father. Annie is the demon child. When we meet her, she won't be named Annie for reasons. There's seriously nothing in here. Yeah, we got a horn now, and the horn's going to let us get into the water area. And now, blessedly, an hour and 40 minutes into this stream, we're gonna get to explore a new area, and I imagine we're gonna have a time of it. Did he get it on with a succubus? I don't know if it's actually been revealed yet. I don't know if I actually ever read the book that talks about it. I might not have. Let's see, swag bag. No. Gold leaf, do you have it? King's Diary. Yeah, I don't think I ever read the King's Diary. So here, let me add this, add this, add this, remove this. Can we just read it or do we need to decode it? All right, we're unable to decode it. We just use the decoder on this. Use the decoder on the diary. No. Okay, so basically, the king got a hold of the book. Bullshit happened. The king isn't necessarily wholly human anymore. Sexual assault happened. Child is a devil. Horrible, horrible, horrible. This game gets dark towards the end. The ending that we're going for is going to end up with us killing the king, killing the demon child. We're basically going to be killing everything. We're going full murder hobo on this. Everybody dies, including Rove half the time. Okay. So shit's gonna get real, and the fights are gonna get a lot nastier when we go down these stairs, so I wanna get us popped up as best we can. Like, God sort them out. That's exactly it, Shavarius. As long as I'm killing— oh my god, as long as I'm killing everything and— wow. This would be like a TPK when we were first starting out. Now this is probably just mostly going to be obnoxious. Old leaf blades. It's gonna be obnoxious for everybody except Ela, who these things are probably going to rip apart because he has the defensive capabilities of like an infant. Ela getting the PTSD, yeah. Yeah. Alright. Cure lesser condition. Let's wake Rove up. Ela, you have a magic missile spell. That'll do some damage. Leaf. Give these killer rats some blades. Once Rove's up, the fireballs are going to start flying and these things are going to just melt. So if whatever you write in the book becomes true, with a twist, I wonder what would happen if you wrote in there your family would have a kid and nothing else. I don't know. What would happen is like a child would be born, the mother would die in childbirth, and the father would die of grief. So there would be a child and nothing more. At least that's how I DM it. All right, give me a fireball, Rove. The monkey, yeah, exactly. It is absolutely like 100% just monkey paw bullshit. All right, we got this. Easy. 2,000 XP, not bad. All right, let's go. Let's do this. Okay, who has the horn? Use the Horn of Souls. The horn issues a haunting call which echoes far across the water. Eventually, the echoes fade away and only the quiet rippling of the river is left to fill the silence. From out of the mists, a dark figure slowly emerges. Riding atop a slender boat, he gently guides it to the shore. I am Sharon. Ferryman of Ashes, Sharon Karen, however it's pronounced. Do you have any ashes for me? No. Do you wish passage? Yes. The fee is 500 gold. Will you pay? Yes. So, this guy is the hardest fight in the game. We can't fight him yet. We will eventually get to a point where we can fight him, and he is by far the... His whole shtick is that every one of his attacks kills something. Once a round, he kills somebody. So you basically have to kill him in 6 rounds. A circular emblem is engraved upon the floor, adorned with many strange runes and mystic symbols. All right, that's just the boatman thing. Go ahead and save. What an ash hole. Boo! Get out! Okay, the Isle of Minos, Tomb of the Damned. Resting at the foot of the gate, you find a book and a key. Book of the Damned, Key of the Damned. All right, the book goes to Ro, the key goes to Chunk. The save begins. All right, Rove. Can we read the book? Curse of Minos. He who dwells upon the Isle of Minos is doomed by the curse of Minos and shall become manifest in the form of a demon. And he shall be given the knowledge that his freedom lies with the destruction of others, and thus shall he live out his days forever imprisoned, awaiting one with whom a battle may be fought and won, and in his triumph be released from the sad curse upon him. Never shall he know that it is only by the victory of an enemy who shall knowingly risk life to destroying his that his freedom can be won, and such an enemy in victory may suffer himself in the deed. I drop it. Stop giving me quest items that I can't get rid of! Okay. Use. You damned. Cast pun, 7 psychic damage. Yeah. On a joke, I am in Kingmaker. A robe that lowers your con to 6, con by 6. That is, in fact, a perfect item for Ro, which I would never give him in any of Alcat's games because their fucking balance is so fuck busted that if you're not basically capping all of your stats always and forever, you're just gonna die all the time. From a quest, yeah. Oh, it begins. Okay. So these are demons. I don't remember if anybody has Astral Gate yet. Goldleaf might. Oh boy. Like I said, this is when the fights are going to start getting really tough. Please tell me you have Astral Gate. Oh, you don't. I hate everything. Hold monsters. Max that shit out on the second group. Rove prismic missiles. Yeah. Everybody's slowing down. Chunk punched a demon in the fucking mouth. Gives no shits. Oh, they're sleeping us. That's wonderful. And of course it hits Rove. Because who else would it hit? Energy blasts. All right. More sleep. Everybody except Goldleaf, who cast her spell and fizzled because that's just how she rolls. Ooh, Goldleaf. Try hold monsters again. Wizardry is an adventure in nap time. It's an adventure in suffering is what it is. There we go. Wow, held one of them. This is less than ideal. I dare say I'm gonna reload. I think we've lost this fight purely because my entire party is having a nap. Is this just a static encounter? Okay, only 6 of them this time. Ela. Just bite. Scimitar actually Swell, try silencing these guys. Goldleaf. Blinding flash maybe, and Row prison pistol. I got a couple of them. Oh, here we go. Nauseous. One of them's dead. We got one. Ah, and the rest are silenced. Okay. All right. We're in the running. We're in the running. I love that they're wasting their turns trying to cast spells. One of them's nauseated. I don't know what kind of resistance these guys have. I could cheat and look, but that doesn't feel particularly sporting. We'll figure things out as we go here. Goldleaf, lob a blade into their area. Oh, let's try Psychic Blast. See if Rove can, like, mind wipe these dudes. I love seeing them trying to cast spells and failing. I love it. So satisfying. Okay, so they are susceptible. Oh!
Oh!
Psionic Blast drives things insane. Oh, that's real good. Because that means they'll attack each other. Oh, that's real good. Damage on it's kind of shit, but an AoE insanity spell? Oh, I am all for that. When he ate damage with that Vulcan Hammer, that's pretty satisfying. Wizardry 8, the party loves it too. Oh man, getting your own characters driven insane. That's always like a horrible time. Fragments of bones lie heaped upon the alcove, the final remains of some lost soul doomed upon the Isle of Minos. Got anything good? A nodashi, a fauchard, some chain hose, and a cylinder of ash. I think nodashis are two-handers and Ela dual wields. Chain hosen are probably an upgrade for him, though, and the cylinder of ash we can give to Sharon. Alright, Ela, did you just get another upgrade? I dare say you did. Her leggings are -4. Chain hosen are -8. Look at that. It's weird playing a wizardry game and getting. Oh, he can't use. Oh, chain hosen are boots. All right. Anyways, it's weird playing a wizardry game and getting gear upgrades. Doesn't happen as often in Wizardry 7. Oh, man. The faces in the fucking Might and Magic games? Yes, absolutely. Fucking Might and Magic 6. I think it's Might and Magic 6 that has like the real people faces. Man, those are funny. No cat boots, sadly. He's just got little booties on instead. One group. I hate that I have to like reset the game. I want to say in 7 they let you quit out of the combat menu. They don't let us do it here. I can take a group. Two groups. Too much. God, we're gonna have to maybe rest after this, which is a horrifying prospect to me. All right, Rove. Fuck these dudes up. Seven was the CG? Yeah, I think it was. Yeah, I think 6 is right. And yeah, the CG faces weren't. The CG faces weren't as good as either the real life ones or the old pixel art ones. Because it was like that, like, late 90s CG where it just looked like shit. The bad dark days of 3D in games where it was the hot new thing and everybody was doing it, but it all just looked so bad. Ow. I wasn't paying attention. I didn't see if they got silenced. I'm working under the assumption. I love it. I love seeing them insane. Days of brown. That was like the 2000s. Yeah, where like the color schemes and everything was just brown. Horrible, horrible. And then it was like, it went from brown to, then you were brown and everything had quick time events, which was equally just, All right, Rove's driven everything insane. Maybe a magic missile? Hey guys, we discovered poop. Ooh, crit from Ela. Always happy to see him. I feel like we should be getting some levels here before too much longer. Terror scroll, no. Ha ha! Called that shit. I give him oratory or I'm gonna give him oratory. Yeah, Ela's been pretty good about critting things. He's got actually a really high Kirijutsu skill. Like a 66. What's this? Alright, I'm gonna dump these 6 points in the Thaumaturgy to get him another level of spells. And then for his next two levels, it's gonna all be going into Kirijutsu before we multiclass him back. Okay. Was this room just bullshit? It smells like it. Outside the gate, a raft made of heavy planks is floating in the water. There's a heavy steel cable attached to the wall, which then runs into and around a spool and crank device aboard the raft. We are not fucking with the raft. Anything here? No. I am gonna make a map note for this, though. Raft. Ela is occasionally very useful. I'm not gonna say he's a linchpin of the party, but he's pretty useful. He's gonna be even better in 7. Man, these fights scare me. These are terrible fights. They're manageable. Oh, really? They're manageable. But I am just not having a time here. Ela the sometimes contributing. Ela the tentatively useful. Oh, no encounter. All right. Ah, shit, it's the minnow demon. Oh, I knew this thing was in here. I just couldn't remember where. 1,000 lambs shall be slaughtered to create the emptiness from which I moves death to lift the bane of Minos. All appears to live in peace to die. Okay. I don't know what you're saying there, buddy, but it doesn't sound right. So this is a boss. I don't remember what this dude's capable of, but I do remember him hitting like a freight train. We write good. He's very excited. Really excited. Oh my god, that's gonna be a delicious fucking chili. And good on you for actually putting meat into it. I know that there are people that swear by chili with no meat, and I think they're godless heathens. So, good job for doing it the right way, Celt. Beta 5 kilograms? It's a lot of kilograms. He complains about burning sensation. He is a living, breathing burning sensation. Chunk. Poisoning him. Scimitar. We're not gonna be able to blind this or terrify this guy, I'm sure. Are you weakening him? Gold leaf. Bless. Just yes. Rove. Fire shield. Oh, it cast blink. Oh, we silenced it. All right. That's a win. So it is a spellcaster then, because it can cast blink. So hopefully this makes it a little bit more approachable. Actually, back up. Was it Ela that I had? Yeah, I'm just gonna have Ela and Sin lob chilling touch on this thing because it seemed to do pretty good damage. Can we itching skin it perhaps? We're gonna make it burn in all of the wrong places. Let's haste the party. Rove. How about a deep freeze? Unaffected. God damn it, Rove. One job. Get meditate at level 8. It's already painful to regen to full. What you get for playing Project 99, Ela? You suffer, but you like it. those, that 20 minutes you spend gaining your mana back, that's when you need to, like, just get your nipple clamps going, you know. Make it hurt so good. Level 1 deep freeze? Ah, it's blinked out. Shit, that was a waste. Okay, susceptible to acid. That Vulcan hammer, though. God damn it, Rove. I am so glad I silenced this dude. I remembered him being a melee powerhouse, but he's mostly, it looks like, just trying to throw spells to fuck us over. Gold leaf. Alright, blinding flash, I guess. Rove, you've just been terrible, so just, like, magic missile him. Oh, hey, look at that. Rove did damage. Oh, shit! Silence wore off. Ouch. Oh, yeah, we won. Never mind. 10,000 XP, though. Oh, hey. You gonna spit more words at me, game? Even as the dust settles from the dead Mino demon, a ghostly visage appears, the soul of a man once held captive by the curse of the Isle of Minos. Thee has released me. For years I have been trapped upon the Isle of Minos, cursed not by the deeds, but by words. Mine was the crime of spoken murder, for I did slay another by word alone, and with word alone did he die. As surely as if I had wielded a sword, his eyes did turn dull and glaze over, his mind ceased to function, and warmth drained from his smile. In that single first moment I said, believe, for as the essence of man is born unto wonder. God, you killed a guy, we get it. On that day when I first spoke of truth, then did I die, this he that was me, and only the fading echoes of thoughts long ago did serve as the remainder of life once remembered. Such was my curse on the Isle of Minos. A lesson of distant voices which hearken blackened water. A blessing be upon ye, ye who look anew. Leave curses for the empty, the feeble, blinded, who must sayeth true. What the fuck did you even just say, ghost man? Go back to bed. My brains hurt. Alright, let's heal Rove. Let's continue healing Rove. Let's also heal Ela a little bit, I guess. Wow, that was a shitbox of a heal spell. Swell, very disappointing. This is why we have Gold Leap, though, and this is also why she has a shitload of magic. Good enough. Save. Good lord. Anybody else smell something? Key of Minos, a studded hauberk, Beastmaster, and Cylinder of Ash. And another 5,000 XP. Beastmaster is actually a pretty good spear, but we have no Valkyrie, so it's getting left behind. Cylinder of Ash. Studded hauberk. Let's see. Alright, Ela has a breastplate, which is 8. A studded hauberk is also 8. But a studded hauberk is usable by samurai, whereas a breastplate is not. So the studded hauberk is actually an upgrade for Ela, and the key of Minos is a key. How much is Beastmaster worth, actually? We might take this just to sell it. I want to have a bunch of money in this, because when we go to play the next one, I'm going to be selling a bunch of shit to... Well, before we go to the next one, I'm going to do stuff off stream to kind of, like, prepare the party, like, get certain items for them and stuff. And one of the things I want to do is convert basically all of our money into resurrection potions, because resurrection potions transfer between games, and it'll basically be a source of, like, I'll have 1,000 of them, and it'll give me a huge fund to start in Wizardry 7. Beastmaster 7, Fighter, Valkyries, and Lords. Oh, it's actually one-handed. Really? Beastmaster's a sword. Oh, I thought it was a spear. That 5-7, or 5-12, I think that's actually an upgrade for Ela as well. Oh, and chunk level. Neat. Chunk, just dump it all into Skullduggery. I don't know what you're talking about, Ela. The itemization is fine. Alright, so this is 5 to 12 damage with no bonus to hit, whereas the Sword of Striking is 1 to 8 with a plus 2 bonus to hit. Let's have a look at the cat here. So the first thing I want to do, swap some of his gear off. Oh, he has a chain hauberk, not a breastplate. I thought he had a breastplate on. Armor. Body. Chain hauberk. Ah, the chain hauberk is better than the studded. I'm going to dump it, though, because it's one less thing to worry about. Goodbye, chain hauberk. Ela's losing a point of AC. That's okay. No. Swag. Remove. Beastmaster. So I'm curious, can you dual wield Beastmaster? No. Because of course not. All right. Well, I'm having him use Beastmaster anyways. There. I am going to hold on to the Sword of Striking, though. So now I can actually drop the Leather Hauberk. So Ela's actually looking in pretty good shape for when he swaps back to Samurai. Admittedly, he's like 200,000 experience points away from being able to do so. But, you know, what's a couple 100,000 experience points between this party and a shitload of demons and the undead? You love Wizardry 6, I'm glad to hear it. We got a lot ahead of us yet. Okay, we can't go out there. But I think with that key that we just got, we can get into this central area, which should get us access to the fucking fountains. Please. I wonder how they come up with item names. A session of log, but then I don't know. Video games. Oh god. I don't think we have any mana for a silence spell, at least not from Swell. No. I know someone else in this party can cast silence, but I don't recall who. Sin? No. No. Old Leaf? I could have sworn somebody else in this party could cast silence. Rove. Rove! Fucking do it, bro! We got the hold monsters off at least. That'll get a couple of them. Hey, Metal Bianco, good to see you, man. Hope you're doing well. Hope grocery shopping wasn't too plagued by elderly people like poor Ela's is. That's right, you shits. All you can do is maul the front row with your melee attacks. So those fountains in the back, one of them restores hit points, and I think hit points and stamina, and the other is mana. So that's why this is like the best spot in the game to grind, because we can just fight these fights that are worth, you know, thousands of experience points and then just immediately top ourselves up. We can go ham on these fights without feeling bad about like having to, you know, conserve resources at all. And there are even nastier fights down this staircase. There's like a bunch of undead down there, which would probably fuck us up pretty good. But I am, of course, going to go down there and, you know, I have to fuck around and find out. Y'all know how it works. Rove, mind bullets. This is, in fact, a grinder spot. Yes. I don't know how much we're gonna grind, but we might grind a little bit. It's like, oh man. Like, at least before multi-classing happens, on the low end, it's 230,000 XP. And I don't think anybody in this party is sitting at 100,000. So, there's... Yeah, we're gonna at some point need to do some a little bit, you know, just some a little bit of a little bit of the bump and grind. That's okay. I wonder if these guys are susceptible to fireballs. Let's find out. I would hope that they are, but realistically, I assume that they're not, because they're demons. Chunk's damage is slowly going up a little bit. 18 damage with that Beastmaster. Ela's fucking things up. Absolutely. Chunk knows only the way of the fist, and he's really good with it. The melees have kind of come into their own now. Swell's got a Vulcan hammer that can hit for like 25. Ela's got a Beastmaster sword that's pretty decent. Chunk fists things until they die, you know. Oh, blessed health and stamina. I'm surprised we haven't fought any of the other enemies that you can bump into in this area. This area isn't all just night gaunts. There are like, I think there are dragons down here that we can fight, or like sea monsters or something. All right, and this is the Fountain of Mana. And yes, and then you play Wizardry 7 with a fresh party and you're like, where is all of the equipment upgrades that I would love to have? And the game's just like, lol, play Wizardry 6. Party's just drowning themselves eternally in these fountains. You love to see it. Okay, so my assumption is that should have everybody pretty well topped up. Oh yeah. Oh, hey guys. Nice to meet you. You chose poorly. Really, really, really poorly. I'm gonna laugh if Swell botches the casting of this silence spell, silences the entire party, and we just get absolutely rolled by these things. It's coming. I know it is. Rove. Imagine nowadays, oh man, you gotta play Diablo 3 to have gear in Diablo 4. That would be crazy. Absolutely crazy. I mean, I guess you kind of have that with like alts, but it's not really the same. Oh no. Swell, did you botch that silence spell? Swell. You son of a bitch. I called it. I called it. Oh no, he was just slow in acting. Okay. Oh, I saw one of them wasn't affected. But ideally, this blades is gonna just, yeah, mow through him. We're okay. Fireball? Yeah, these things, oh no, okay, so fireball does hurt them. They've just got some magic resistance in there somewhere. I do definitely notice that Chunk isn't dealing nearly as much damage with his unarmed attacks as he was when he was a ninja. He was like routinely dealing like double digits, and now he's like, on a good hit, he'll hit for like 8 or 9. Swell runs away. I love it. Better have gotten XP for that. How are we actually looking? Swell's at 87. His next level is 128,000. Chunk's next level is 115. Scimitar's actually probably nearing a level. 179. And then these guys are all 160. So yeah, we are a ways away from levels. Let's have everybody drink. Time to grind for 4 hours. I don't know. We're handling the fights. They're not necessarily like what I would consider easy. Like, we have to take our time with them, but The small underground mausoleum smells of mold and ferment, and perhaps a bit of stale corpses. Your intrusion feels to be the first to disturb the rotting languor after many years of peace. So I know that there are skeletons in here. I don't know how bad they're gonna be. Key of the Damned? No. Is that the only key that we have, or are these like... These are probably special keys. Oh, what are you gonna hit me with, game? I know there's skeletons down here.